you find it.
Amen.
Amen. Perhaps it was a disappointment to some that the world did not come to the end on yesterday. Don't laugh at the people.
Amen.
Because it's going to happen. It's going to happen, brothers and sisters. We just don't know when.
Amen.
It's bound to happen. It was prophesied that no man knows the day nor the hour when the Son of Man shall come. But he will come. The church ought to say amen. In the night. He may not come at night, but he will come as a thief in the night. Amen. 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 Come with me to Revelation chapter 21 in your Bibles. Revelation chapter 21. Amen. 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 You've gotten so accustomed to the pastor saying you may keep your seats and you'll pop it up like popcorn this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 21, the pastor's going to read for our consideration from that chapter, beginning perhaps at verse 4. There's a lot of good reading in this chapter.
Amen.
At your leisure, you ought to try reading all of it.
Amen.
I'm going to begin the reading at verse 4. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. You see that?
Amen.
And there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain.
Amen.
Ain't that something?
Amen.
For the former things are passed away.
Amen.
And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new.
Amen.
And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful.
Amen.
And he said unto me, It is done.
Yes.
I am Alpha and Omega,
yes.
The beginning and the end.
Amen.
I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life free.
Yes.
Verse 7, He that overcometh,
yes,
shall inherit all things. And I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Also verse 8. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and the murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone,
yes,
which is the second death.
Amen.
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 Turn to your neighbor, will you, while you're yet standing. Take that neighbor by the right hand and look them in the face. And hold their hand a moment.
Amen.
Saying after me, Good morning, neighbor.
Good morning.
So nice to see you.
So nice to see you.
This morning. With God's help.
With God's help.
And our prayer.
And our prayer.
Pastor's going to preach about.
Being.
An overcomer.
Amen.
Thank you so much. You may be seated, please. With your Bibles open.
Amen.
Being.
Being
an overcomer.
Yeah.
father you go away, the father you have to come back. Amen.
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 Amen. All right. Let me say it, thank God. I'm glad to see Brother Melvin Henry here.
Amen.
I'm really glad to see him, Melvin.
Amen.
Good.
Amen.
Amen. Glad to see all of our visitors. Glad to see Dominique. Illness, and they owe everybody.
Yeah.
So how can they have a lot of money? after we die somehow, somebody believes that we must have some money under the mattress. Amen. Oh, my brothers and sisters, somebody's gone to sleep, might have even started yet. This is not a sleeping room. Amen. I've been letting you sleep during the message, and I've been doing you a disservice. I need to keep you woke for the sermon. Sleep from the singing. If you must sleep, but stay awake for the message. Because that's what's going to save you. You don't get saved because they hear a lot of good singing. Amen. Praise God all you want. But you need to hear some preaching. And the message that I have today, and I'm burdened with it, is a message that all of us need to think about. Whether or not you personally are an overcomer. And you need to think about it, brothers and sisters, because they are the ones. Only the overcomers are they who will inherit all things. Amen. I was so glad to hear the choir sing that this morning. He that overcometh shall inherit all things. You can sing that part of it over and over and over again. Amen. Because there are a lot of us who sang hallelujah, I made it over. Ain't gonna make it over. There are churches all over this land and country, yet evil seems to be at an all-time high. But remind you, if you will, and you will find a mega church in many cities, and more than one. People are gathering in there, rushing in there, brothers and sisters, and many of them are actually on that way to hell on the side of me. Because they have not embraced Christ as their personal Savior for sure. Amen. My sleep is gone back to sleep. Amen. It's not a sleeping room. Wake up. Wake up and don't sleep at this part of the message. It's the end of the message. Amen. All you coming here together now, this is not the place for that. Amen. Amen. You come to the house of God to hear the word of God. Amen. I'm going to help you all I can this morning. Amen. I'm going to help you all I can to stay awake today. God wants you to hear what I've got to tell you. He would never have given it to me to tell you about it. See, the devil has always been the enemy. And he wants some of us to miss the message. Every time you go to sleep in the message, the devil has gotten the victory. Because he's kept you from hearing what your soul needs. The bread from heaven that we can have till we want no more. Amen. Is your Bible still open? I'm saying to you this morning that those who faithfully persevere as children of God are they who overcome. They overcome Satan and sin and ungodliness and will be thrown, my brothers and sisters, into the blessed place God wants them to have. The overcomer will be able to inherit all things. Now, what are all things? We think about it, brothers and sisters. What are all the things that God has for us? First of all, I need to inform you that eyes have not seen. Have you heard about it? That God has in store for us. Amen. Some of them are listed in the very book we call Revelation. Turn with me to the second chapter of Revelations. I invite you to count how many times that I will lead you into the discussion of overcoming. It's in your Bible if you haven't torn it out. Now, if you found the second chapter of Revelations, I want you to take notice, my brothers and sisters, and if you've got your own Bible, you ought to mark it, because you'll need to call on it again and again. Look it with me at verse 7 of that second chapter. You see it?
Amen.
He that hath an ear.
Yes, sir.
He that hath an ear.
Yes, sir.
Let him hear.
Yes.
What the Spirit saith unto the churches.
Amen.
I missed this in this morning's message because I failed to give a little clue to these preachers. When you get to seminary, they're going to talk to you a great deal about context, 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 context. You're going to hear it over and over again. Context, context, context. But you need to know that there's more in reading the Word of God than simply context. There's text and context. But there's also the Holy Spirit who has to have a voice in the Word of God. He's our comforter, and our teacher.
Amen.
So while you look at the context, also seek to hear what the Holy Spirit says in between the lines. I listened to a question, Bible question, this past week from a young person who wanted to know whether or not give and it shall be given unto you in good measure. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall men give into your bosom. That's Luke 6. And 38. And the preacher said it didn't have anything to do with money. Nonsense, nonsense, nonsense. Nonsense, nonsense, nonsense. Every time you see the word give in scripture, it has something to do with money. I'm going to say that again. Every time you see the word give, it has something to do with money. Even if it's for give.
Yeah.
And forgive sometimes has this to do with money. Forgiving debts of money that folk owe you. Some of us walk around here mad with folk because we loaned them some money and they didn't give it back to us. Sometimes it's necessary for the believer, yes, even the believer, to forgive the debt. I mean forgive money.
And
somebody you gave it to. Or loaned it to. Amen. So you can keep on being blessed.
Amen.
Look at me any way you want, but it's in the Word of God. And I'm not ashamed to tell you what the Word of God has to say. Yes, they want you to look at context, context, context.
Yeah.
You remember, not just context, 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 but Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost is our teacher.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. See, men want to minimize scripture. They want to make scripture fit in their little case so it doesn't expand beyond their dimension. I want you to look with me this morning. He that hath an ear, let him hear. That's what the scripture says right here. You have it in your mouth. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. And now to him that overcometh, saith the scripture. You see it? Will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God.
Amen.
Most of us will remember the Garden of Eden. But God put man and let man stay and told him not to eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And the first tree man wanted to eat of was the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. So we know men chose knowledge over life. They could have eaten of the tree of life. Amen. And the only reason God put man out of the garden when he ate of the tree of knowledge, that he would not eat of the tree of life and live forever in that fallen state. You and I have no idea what it would be like to live forever as a sinner. All have sinned. Not just y'all. All have have sinned and come short of the glory of God. I'm preaching to sinners, you're listening to a sinner.
Amen.
All have sinned. Yeah. this. But brothers and sisters, this is the message for us today. Be an overcomer.
Be an overcomer.
Can you say it?
Be an overcomer.
Amen. If I was in one of them mega churches, I might tell you to take it in with that, but no, you can just say it. Be an overcomer. Say that. Some of you need to say, I'm going to stop being an overcomer. Oh, wake up this morning. Amen. You who are around your neighbor that you see sleeping, wake them up. Amen. Don't let them sleep through this. Amen. Don't wake them up with no apology. Just touch them and wake them up. It doesn't matter who it is. They want to hear this message. That's why they're here. In verse 11, when you see first, he either had an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. Not context, but what the Spirit, the Holy Spirit of God, saith to the churches. And here's what he says, he that overcometh shall not be hurt in the second death. That second death is the fire that burneth with fire and brimstone. Fire and brimstone. And I'm depending on you to keep the neighbors woke. The neighbors asleep, don't be ashamed. Touch them and wake them up. Don't let them sleep through this message. Maybe next Sunday, perhaps. But this Sunday, wake them up. So we might want to stay with me this morning. God wants all of us to hear the message. Now that you've come all the way here, my goodness, look how blessed you are. The Lord brought you all the way here. Now, yeah, maybe I'm still like I used to be. The Lord wants you to hear all of this. Amen. He that overcometh, the Lord's going to see to it. That you won't go to hell and burn in the fire and brimstone.